Today on the BV3D channel, we'll learn about a handy infill pattern that can reduce the amount of filament you use and cut time off longer prints, so you'll want to stick around for this one. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. In the past year and a half, we've seen an explosion of new, faster printers coming to market. But there are still a ton of older, slower 3D printers out there. They're perfectly good machines, they just take a little bit longer to finish a print. And there's nothing wrong with that. But there's also nothing wrong with adjusting a setting now and then to speed things up either. So there are a lot of different settings available in your 3D printer slicing software. And slicers have a few, or sometimes more than a few, pre-built collections of settings that you can choose from. These standard presets, or printing profiles, are designed to help ensure success with the majority of models that you might print without you having to adjust anything. They control the layer height, the number of walls or perimeters that form the outer surface of the model, and the way the inside of the model is printed too. That last thing is called the infill pattern, and there are plenty of those to choose from too. And today, we're learning about one that can reduce the amount of filament needed to print a model. It can also reduce your printing time so you get a finished print faster. And it's called Lightning Infill. Lightning Infill probably won't be a good choice for everything you print. Small models will likely not benefit from it. And if you're printing a functional part and you need strength, stick with something like grid or gyroid infill and increase your infill percentage. But for ornamental or decorative prints, busts, character figures, and other models that are destined to sit on a shelf, this can be a good choice. Particularly on larger models, you'll see the filament and the time savings really start to kick in. So let me show you how to do this. Now in this video, I'll be using a stock Creality Ender 3 S1 Pro and the Ultimaker Cura Slicer. The model I'm going to print is McGybeer's CaliDragon. But I'm not going to print it small. Instead, I'm going to scale it up to 300%. If I slice this using the standard quality print profile, Cura says it'll take almost 8 hours to print. And it'll use 82 grams of filament, which is just over 27 meters. In the preview, we can see what the standard quality profile's cubic infill looks like inside the model. It's shown in orange. Cubic infill provides an internal structure that gives the model a lot of strength. But this model isn't going to need a lot of strength. It's just going to live on a shelf and look pretty. So I'll change the infill from cubic to lightning and slice the model again. Now the interior of it is mostly hollow. Lightning infill looks cool. It grows and branches from the outside of the model inward. It looks kind of like lightning, which I guess is where it gets its name. The infill is generated only where necessary to support the upper surfaces of the model from the inside while they're being printed. So, using lightning infill, Cura says it'll only take about 6 hours to print instead of 8. As a bonus, it will be lightening the weight of the finished print, using only 39 grams, or a little over 13 meters of filament. So, to test it, I printed it. And it printed in only 5.5 hours, and it looks really good. I have exactly zero issues with this print. Visually, there's nothing to distinguish this from a model that's stuffed full of infill, but it feels strangely light for its size. Cura said it was going to weigh 39 grams, and it does, in fact, weigh in at 39 grams. So, I'm struck by lightning. Infill's ability to finish a print more quickly and use less filament. In this particular example, it cut the amount of filament needed pretty much in half, and it cut 2 hours off the print time, too. It's available in lots of slicers, including Cura, Prusa Slicer, Bamboo Studio, and more, so check yours to see if it's got that infill style. Big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up, and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have to talk about lightning, so I'm gonna bolt. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool with a little less filament.